Think about the level of understanding of suffering that you walked away with from that film.
Yes.
And I know, you know, you've talked about fake Christianity, that we're not really telling people the truth about following Christ and the suffering that comes with it. That was a huge gift to you. But I think of you now as you are going to play the sequel to Passion of the Christ. So you're going to really enter in themes of resurrection, of victory, of life, all these things that are part of that story, but a different part. What do you think that story is going to give you that's new?
Well, in this one, it's not as if Jesus walks out of the tomb and there's little Easter bunnies and Easter eggs walking around, or moving around, you know. They were in hiding. They were terrified of what was to come, mm-hmm. you know. Mel references, you know, where did Jesus go after he died? He descended into hell. What's that experience like, you know? But for the most part, I can refer to that because Mel has referred to it himself. So, but that's all I can say about it, because I will go to Mel Hell if I go any more into that.
No, and I'm not asking for giveaways from the film, but more about like your own spirituality. Where do you think this is going to take you? That's new.
I don't know. It's a mystery. Mm. When I went into the Passion, I did not know we were doing it in Aramaic. I did not know we were doing it in Hebrew. I did not know we were doing it in Latin.
Capilu, stay. Tanadami. The breatha chadatha di hivlechom wathrabin di mashlech hatayin. Udu denala de crani.
And I was terrified. I didn't think I could do it, but obviously I could do it. A lot of times that's the thing. God, he knows we can do things before we can do it. And I was like, are you sure you want me to be an actor? This has to be wrong. Me? Me? Yes, you, you know. But he did. He knew I could. And when Mel came to me, you know, asked me to do it. I said, yeah. And a couple of days, he called me back. And at some point in the conversation, I said, oh, my God. He said, what? I said, I just realized my initials are JC, and I'm 33 years old. And he says, God, you're freaking me out. I'm off the phone.
That's a great moment.
But it happened. I mean, it really happened. I had no clue. It just dawned on me. I didn't even correlate that was going to be. And had I known that I was going to suffer that much on the movie, I had no idea it was I mean, as far as I'm concerned, I don't know a lot of people that want to get hit by lightning. I certainly didn't.
Nope.
When I was on the cross and I was in incredible pain, there was a man named Ken, and he would, every day, he's like, Jim, and he was distracting me because he wanted me to put headphones on so I could listen to a song. And I said, no, I don't want to do that. I'm in the Aramaic world here, and I got to think. Every day I would get up there, and sure enough, about 15, 20 minutes in, I would just, you know, you're spinning around, the cross is going back and forth, your shoulder keeps getting ripped out, because you're right next to a cliff, and there's five knot winds that come up, and then all of a sudden it shoots up to 30, and then it hits the cross, right, like a stick, it just boom, and that rips your shoulder out, because you're tied in.
Mm.
And so Mel goes, what can I do to help? And I just leaned over and would throw up. And Ken finally just had it. He came up at the top and he goes, listen to this. And it was Michael W. Smith's song, Above All. And I said, all right, just hang on. And I would listen to it. And I would listen to it again and again. I just played it on repeat. And then he would come up in between takes and just put the song on. I would listen to the words in my, you know, when you cry, it doesn't just happen in your face. You can feel it in your heart. It begins to swell. And when it gets hot like that, you can do anything. Love can make you do anything. I couldn't feel the pain anymore. I'd get up there at 10:30 on that thing, not every day, but many days in a row. My makeup times were from 2 a.m. Till 10 a.m. And then from 10:30 to 4:30, I was freezing. And that's the light. That's the only light we have. Mm-hmm. But the makeup, putting all that on. And we did all of this, but what you saw was this. So all of this other stuff got cut out of the film. Mm-hmm. Mel was continually perfecting it, moving the cameras and saying, no, no, but we got something today. Let's try this tomorrow. And then the weather changed. And we can't use it. He says, well, let's use this dark stuff. And then suddenly the shoulder's dislocated. And they'd work around that. And so something was birthing through this suffering. When I put that music on, my heart got swollen and had it just started coming. I didn't have to act anymore. I was just, I could feel his heartbreak for all of us. That all of Jesus, so many of his children don't love him. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, you know, I love you. I know you love us, but I want you to know I love you. And I want to do this with you. I don't want to do it alone. I want them to see you, and I want you to be with me. And I couldn't feel any more pain.